ومن أحسن قولا ممن دعا إلى الله وعمل صالحا وقال إنني من المسلمين.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على رسوله محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. So inshallah, starting today, we'll be starting a new series. Alhamdulillah, in the past, we had completed our Smiles and Tears of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But however, we want to start another one. And so today, inshallah, we'll be starting a new series. And I had, you know, subhanAllah, there was a lot of thinking about what do I want to call this new series. And first of all, I want to revolve this series around Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I mean, subhanAllah, me personally, I teach the seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the more I study about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the more I learn about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the more I teach about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, I'm just simply amazed and blown by what an amazing person he was. I mean, every single aspect of life, how he did things, it is subhanAllah. It is for this reason you come back to the ayah of the Quran in Surah Al-Ahzab, where Allah says, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنًا, that the best example for all of us is in the example and is in the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And so subhanAllah, you know, one of the things that we always do is that no matter what situation we are in, even during this crisis time, yes, we may not be going to work, but we're always around our families. We're always going to be around people all the time. We cannot get away from people. We're always going to be around people. So the question is that how would Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam treat other people? So, for example, how would he treat his neighbors? How would he treat his relatives? How would he treat his family members? That includes his daughters. That includes his son-in-law. He was the son-in-law to someone else. He was a son-in-law to Abu Bakr radiallahu ta'ala and Umar ibn Khattab radiallahu ta'ala. How did he deal with his stepchildren? You know, subhanAllah, today we find many Muslims, they mistreat their stepchildren. They get married again and children are coming from another family and they mistreat their stepchildren immensely. So we're going to, inshallah, talk about all that. How did the Prophet ﷺ deal with his enemies? How did he deal with people with disabilities? How did he deal with the homeless? How did he deal with the rich and the poor? How did he deal with people who had low self-esteem? How did he work and how did he treat the women? How did he treat widows? How did he treat children? How did he treat orphans? There are so many people in the community, and the Prophet ﷺ taught us how to work with everyone and how to deal with everyone, how to treat everyone. And this is what I want to go through, inshallah, because when we learn about who Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam was, then inshallah we can become like Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And you know, subhanAllah, going into the tafsir of this ayah, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ, you know, subhanAllah, the ulama, they mention that this ayah is mentioned in Surah Al-Ahzab. Surah Al-Ahzab talks about the battle of trenches, غَزْوَةُ Al-Ahzab, and so forth. And one thing that we learn about that time is that it was one of the most difficult situations for the Muslims. Go back and say the battle of trenches. I mean, they had to dig trenches. The Sahaba had tied stones to their stomach. They came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they had tied a stone to their stomach. The Prophet had two stones tied to his stomach. And you know, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and the Sahaba, it's a blistering cold weather that is taking place. Yet within that, they're breaking rocks, they're digging up a trench. You know how difficult that is? In that difficult situation, the Prophet is the leader. And as they always say, the best way to find and to judge how great a leader is to look at them and judge them based on how they deal with adversity. Everyone deals with good times in an easy way, in good ways. But you really want to know someone, see how they work and see how they conduct themselves in times of adversity. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in that time of adversity, the way he conducted himself was so beautiful that in that same surah, Allah says, your best example is the example of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So in just going through that tafsir, I found out that, you know, subhanAllah, there are many ulama in tafsir al-Qurtubi. We find even Sheikh Sha'rawi rahmatullahi alayhi. They always mention one word in their tafsir, and they use the word qudwa. Qudwa means role model. And so hence I decided to call this program, inshallah, our upcoming series called Qudwatuna, our role model, who? Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Inshallah, we'll be starting very soon, inshallah. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he always keeps Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam as our qudwatuna. Ameen rabbil alameen. Jazakumullah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
إن المسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات والقانتين والقانتات والصادقين والصادقات والصابرين والصابرات والخاشعين والخاشعات والخاشعين والخاشعات والمتصدقين والمتصدقات والصائمين والصائمات والحافظين فروجهم والحافظات والذاكرين الله كثيرا والذاكرات أعد الله لهم مغفرة وأجرا عظيماً.